Before we dive into editing, let's get familiar with the Drupal interface. To log into your website, you'll want to scroll to the very bottom of the page, and in the footer, you'll find a login link. Clicking on this will allow you to log into your site using your normal OSU name.number and password. I'll log in and meet you back here. Now that we're into the site, the Drupal administrative toolbar appears. This dual-layer design consists of all the sections you'll need to access your site. The top layer contains a Manage tab, which is currently selected, and your username. And clicking on this will reveal a few extra links, which aren't very useful for you right now, so I'm going to switch back to Manage. The bottom layer contains links to important tools. Starting at the left, we have a blue Drupal 8 logo, the Content tab, the People tab, a Help link, and all the way at the right, an arrow button to switch the toolbar format. The blue Drupal 8 logo is your link to the front page of the website. No matter how deep you are into the administrative interface, this will take you home. Hovering over this reveals a link to Drupal.org and a logout button. Clicking on the Content tab will bring us to a list of all pages on the site, and this is filterable by different options such as content type or title, and it gives you a good jumping off point for finding content to edit. Hovering over content will reveal an Add Content button, and this is where you can add events and news stories later. The other two options, Add Media and Files, are situational. If there's a need that can't be accomplished via the normal editing tools, we may instruct you to use these. The People tab will bring you to a list of all people on your website. Here you can either add new users or edit their bio information. The final tool, Help, isn't a very useful resource to content editors, because this basically lists out the bug trackers for different modules of code within the website. It's a good tool for us, but not so much for you. To get assistance with your website, you'll want to drop us a line at go.osu.edu/ASCWebServices. And finally, the arrow icon will actually switch your toolbar to a vertical orientation. And this is just an aesthetic change, so if you prefer this style, you can switch whenever you want. Now that we've completed this topic, choose the next video on the right side of the screen, or view the entire playlist with the link on the left.